Just some good old-fashioned H2O. Baby, that's good stuff. Hello, dudes, dudettes, duders, and everyone in between, and welcome to How to Do Everything So You Don't Have To. I am your host, Jesse Kester, who is also the director of ThyU LLC, and we have already covered on this channel how to take a Keynote image with a green screen, like the one you're seeing here, and to feed it through an ATEM, like the one you're seeing here, and to output it over as an overlay with the lower third in the shot you're seeing here. But today, we're taking everything a step further. You know these little lower thirds? Wouldn't it be cool if you could do some, you know, right-on technology on that screen? And this dude here, this fella, this handsome devil right there, he's going to teach you how to. It's me. I'm he. And I'm going to stop talking in the third person right now. I'm going to teach you how to, and by the end of this video, I hope that you love everything you learned and that you had a good time. So let's get into it so that we can get out of it. Before we get into the tutorial proper, I want to go over all the equipment we're using, and to do that, we've got to switch to camera 2. And we're just going to cover everything from left to right. In the upper left, you see a computer monitor with a Zoom meeting going on right now. I am the only person in that Zoom room. The reason I have this loaded up is for proof positive that everything we're doing on the ATEM can be used in a private meeting or a public live stream. You can feed it right into your computer and broadcast this to the platform of your choice. And if we turn on the Chroma Key, you'll see that I've got the little lower third. So this is the final composite image from everything coming into the ATEM. Let's turn that off and continue through the equipment. Next up, we've got the iPad. And the iPad is being used to control the computer. Now, usually when I'm using the iPad, I'm using it as a teleprompter on the camera. This episode is being done without teleprompter. So if it feels a little more loosey-goosey than what you're used to, please, forgive me. If you enjoy it, though, leave a comment down below about how exciting and thrilling this episode was with you at the very edge of your seat, wondering if I'd be able to pull it off. Moving down the line. Next up, we got a jar of H2O, and I use this to lubricate the nodes around here. Continuing across, we've got an ATEM Mini Extreme ISO, and this is a bit of overkill for what we're doing here. You can do everything in this tutorial with an ATEM Mini Pro. You don't even need the ISO. The reason we're using an ATEM Mini Extreme ISO is to combine all of these feeds, pump them into the computer, and to record everything so I can make the tutorial that you're watching. Moving down the line, we've got a small monitor right here, and I'm using this to keep track of all of the five feeds, and we'll go over what those five feeds are in a moment. And finally, almost entirely blocked by your humble host, is the Keynote computer over here on the right. Okay, that's the equipment we're using. Let's go over what those five inputs are. You're looking at input number one right now, and that's our A camera. Input 2 is the over-the-shoulder shot. Input 3 is an overhead camera looking at the ATEM Mini Extreme ISO. Input 4 is the iPad. And input 5 is the laptop computer. All right, now you know all the equipment that we're using, how it's laid out, and how our ATEM is configured. Let's get into how we actually do this right-on effect. The first thing we have to do is connect our laptop to the iPad so that we can use the iPad as a controller. To do that, we're going to go over to the laptop, go to Keynote, Preferences, and go to Remotes. And we need to enable Remotes. Now we're going to head over to the iPad. And if you look in the upper right, there's a little select icon, and next to that is an iDevice with a play button. That's your icon for your remote control. So we're going to tap that. Then we're going to tap Continue. And what it's doing right now is looking for any Keynote presentations that are currently being broadcast on our Wi-Fi network. And if we look over at the laptop, it looks like the iPad has found the laptop. So we're going to click Link. Next thing that will happen is a 4-digit code will come up. Check the iPad. The codes match. Fantastic. You can click Confirm. Now the iPad is actually controlling the laptop, so we can go over to the iPad and start playback on our presentation. And the first slide comes up and it is just a green slide. And now that we have a green slide, it is a good time to turn on our chroma key. And to do that, we're going to go over to the ATEM. And we're going to make sure that our select bus is set to 5, which is the laptop. I'm going to tap 5, and you'll see that it's the laptop image. Go back to 3. So our select bus is set to 5 for the input, and we're set to key 1 chroma. So our key 1 is a chroma key, not a luma key. And we're going to go over to key 1 and turn that on. And you'll notice that the image does not change. Let's advance the slide and it'll animate that that lower third. So now you can see we've got the chroma key on. We can turn it off if you like. We can turn it back on and you see the lower third turning on and off as we do. And also you're noticing that the lights are changing on that. So when it's off, they're white. When it's on and engaged, they are red. Now when we cut to me, the lower third disappears. This is a setting in the ATEM to turn off your chroma key as you cut between cameras or to leave it on until the user turns it off. I have it set to turn off on cuts, so we're going to turn that back on and you can see it's right there in the lower third again. But we're not here for those lower thirds, we're here to do the write-on effect. And to do that, we're going to go over to the iPad. Now what you'll see is that there are three icons in the upper right. The X will close out of the presentation. To the left of the X is a little ViewMaster icon, and this gives you your layout options. We've got it set to current, but we could change it to current and next, current and notes, but I like to leave it as current because this gives you as much real estate as possible for each individual slide. The icon that we're really interested in is this pencil with a squiggly doodle around it. So let's tap that, and you'll see we've got our squiggly doodle menus set up now. First one on the left is just a laser pointer, so you can take that and move your laser pointer around. I'm going to cut to the laptop so you can see how that looks on the actual laptop. And you see there's a bit of delay. It's not completely fluid, but it's better than no pretend laser pointer. And finally, we're going to demo that on camera one. You can see I'm laser pointing it up like a maniac here. Uh-oh. Got a bad case of pink eye, don't I? All right, moving on, back to the iPad. But the nice thing is you can choose these different colors and you can draw on your slide. Let's go over to camera one so you can see this in effect. Simple as can be, you can draw anything you want on the screen. I'm doing hearts because I really like hearts. All right, those are the basics, pretty simple stuff, and that should be enough to get you off to the races, enhancing the quality of your online meetings exponentially. But there's a couple of rules I do want to cover before we peace out on this video. So let's go back to the iPad and let's dirty up this frame a little bit. So we're going to get out our white pen, draw some hearts all over the frame, and we're going to draw them all white. All right, let's advance to the next frame. And when we get to the next slide in our presentation, you'll see that it's empty. And we're going to switch to red because that red will really pop off this blue background. But we're going to stick with hearts, because love is the best thing in the universe. All right, let's go back to slide one, and you'll see that it has retained our drawings from slide one. Those are the white hearts, but if we go to slide number two, thank you for your patience as we go through the animations, you'll see that it has retained the red hearts on slide two. If you want to undo your markings, you can undo markings. Let's do that right now. We're going to draw another little heart so that we have one to get rid of. And then we're going to tap this back button at the bottom to erase our lines one by one. Now let's say you want to get rid of everything all at once. All you have to do is hold down that back button and tap clear all, and your frame is clear. Now that will only clear out the slide you're working on. If we go back to slide one, you'll see that our white hearts remain. So I'm going to hold that down and clear all. And now that slide is clean and ready to go. And that, dudes, dudettes, duders, and everyone in between, is how you can use an iPad to enhance the quality of your online keynote presentations. This tool will be invaluable if you want to hold attention longer and communicate information more clearly to your audience. So I hope to God I hope to God on the off chance that I am one day in your audience, you will be using these techniques to make the most of everyone else's time who's doing you the favor of joining your Zoom meeting. If you enjoyed this video, which I am sure you did because you're still watching right now, I encourage you to give it a like, maybe write a comment down below. You could perhaps click that bell for notifications. Isn't that the best drawing of a bell you've ever seen in your life? Leave a comment. We covered that one. Tell your friends that you know the best YouTube channel in the galaxy, and they'll all be so happy. Anyway, I gotta get out of here. Thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate it. Thank you for making it to the end. If you like this loosey-goosey format, leave a comment below and maybe we'll do some more of those. If you like the tighter videos that are more scripted, leave a comment. If you have no opinion whatsoever, that's actually completely okay. There's no need for you to care about how I format my YouTube videos. But thank you for watching. Please come back anytime. I didn't write an outro, so I don't know how to end this. Bye! Bye, 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 bye.